What's up, gamers? My name's Scyushi, and we're back in some more Trove, and today we're going to be talking about how you can actually prepare for the Leviathan update. But what is the Leviathan update? The Leviathan update is technically called Into the Deep. So this is going to end up being a Trove update that is going to completely overhaul Adventurine, which is the questing resource that you end up getting from the various quest NPCs in your club world and stuff like that. It's gotten a complete overhaul, and that's the part that I'm actually the most excited about, rather than the Leviathans themselves, because they're actually going to be adding quests NPCs to every single biome in the game. And as soon as you end up getting to U6, this is where things will end up getting a lot more interesting and really, really cool, because this right here is actually considered an outpost. So similar to the outpost that you've seen in the Neon City, we've actually these are going to be called outposts as well with the update when it goes live. You will be able to see these on the map. And the reason for that is because each of the different biomes that you end up going in, if you end up finding one of these, there's gonna be an NPC that you can talk to, and he's going to end up giving you various quests, like go kill dungeons in this biome for a while and stuff like that. Unfortunately, it's only a once a day quest. I wish that it was repeatable, because then Adventurine would actually be something grind worthy rather than being time gated garbage, especially with these quests being as cool and exciting as they're going to be, because there's going to be another little crafting table that will allow you to buy a couple specific items for Adventurine. And more importantly, when you end up completing the quests of these dudes, you'll be able to, oh, look at that. You'll be able to end up getting your hands on Adventurine strong boxes. So those will end up having a range of different items that can drop from them. More notably, the rarest item is tradable costumes, with a little less rarer being untradable versions of those costumes. So you'll be able to just use them on yourself, but not be able to trade them with other people. But that is probably the most exciting thing about that update. However, everybody's calling this a Leviathan update just because the Leviathans pretty much are the big showstopper, right? So there's going to end up being new world bosses added to U8, U9, and U10 Geode Topside. The boss in U8 is simple enough, you know, pretty much these guys are going to end up operating the same as an Ultra Shadow Tower boss. So you pretty much are just going to end up searching around. Eventually you'll be able to see them, see their layers on the map, and then you basically go inside and you activate a cursed skull, and then you have 15 minutes or something like that in order to actually defeat one of these guys. Now, in order to prepare for this update, I wanted to let you guys know a couple things that you might not know if you're just starting out with Trove. And that is, you can actually use the sign up link in the description to sign up for Trove, and then anything you buy out of the cash shop, I'll end up making a cut of that. No, that's not what I wanted to tell you guys. That was just a shameless self-promotion, okay? That is actually true. So if you're new to Trove, do that, because it really, really helps me out. It doesn't increase the value of anything in the store or anything. But Trove only lets drops, like items drop, for a total of 8 players. So you've probably noticed this more so with pinata parties that people throw down. So what'll happen is you'll have like tons and tons of pinatas go down, but as soon as you have more than 8 people surrounding those pinatas and nearby, the game is going to randomly distribute those drops to any of the 8 players. Now, pinatas are a little bit different, because the player that throws the pinata is always going to guarantee themselves the drop, whereas everybody else is going to end up fighting for it. So basically the game is randomly going to choose 7 people that are going to get the drop, as opposed to stuff that you're normally farming in the game, like just in normal dungeons and loot and stuff like that. That's only going to drop for a total of 8 people, which is kind of counterproductive when the Leviathans themselves, these are going to be some strong bosses, dude. And it would pay a lot more to end up having more people with you while you're actually fighting these. But unfortunately, that means that you're probably not going to end up having the best odds of getting the drop, which is very, very unfortunate that they don't have it coded as an item that just automatically goes into your inventory, because there are ways that Trove's design has gotten around this limitation. It's a limitation with the game engine. Unfortunately, there's nothing they can change with it. But the reason for this sucking so much is because each of the different tiers of Uber world, like U8, U9, and U10, each of these different Leviathan bosses is going to have a range of different drops. Now, on top of the fact that these guys are going to end up having increased odds of dropping Crystal 3 gear, which already means that they may possibly be the most efficient method of farming for Crystal gear in the game, But I, you know, we gotta wait until it's on the live server because I don't have enough experience with hours and hours and hours of farming Leviathans to let you guys know whether or not the odds are actually that much better than just going for every single dungeon that you can in the, you know, in the GEODE topside. It might end up equaling out to the same thing. You know, you can get a stellar within, I don't know, maybe or a crystal 3, I mean, not a stellar, you can get within like an hour to 16 hours or something like that. And some people I'm sure have gotten even higher than that. Even on my Draco, I ended up getting myself a crystal 3 staff, boys. And I got that within like, I don't know, it was within like 20 minutes or something. It was pretty ridiculous. So in total, to get my crystal 3 staff on my Draco, that took maybe an hour, maybe 2 hours. That's pretty crazy, because with my Neo Ninja, it took me like 16 hours to end up getting it. I was just grinding, and I couldn't get it. So my point is that when the when we end up actually having the Leviathan bosses, then we'll be able to tell whether or not the drops are going to be better. They also will end up dropping unique mounts for each of them, which of course is more mastery. The mounts themselves aren't that cool, honestly speaking. They're not the greatest, but I have a link in the description to all of this stuff if you want to actually see it firsthand. It's all on the test server. And the interesting thing is, the reason why I'm putting this video out, guys, is because even though the Leviathan update just keeps getting delayed, I have a strong feeling that the update is coming very, very soon. I think they've figured things out with the servers, or maybe they've just given up and want to just release the update. The reason I think this is because I ended up getting contacted by them more recently about them partnering with me in preparation for the Leviathan update. This was something that they reached out to me a couple months back, and then the Leviathan update got delayed, and then they didn't really follow through with any of that because they were busy with other things. But now that they're contacting me again, it tells me that there is the possibility that they're actually trying to get the Leviathan update ready to go. And on top of that, we actually had a more recent update on the PTS. So that's the public test server for Trove. The test server is available right now on PC. And all you gotta do is, when you have the glyph launcher open, you literally just click where it says North America or European servers, and you just go to PTS. And then on that test server, we have the Leviathan update already. So that's where I've gotten all the footage for like all of the stuff on the test server already. But again, the fact of the matter is that they had a hotfix more recently that changed that update slightly and made the Leviathan bosses a little bit stronger, which kind of sucks because the one in U10 is cheatingly powerful. Like, it's not even a contest of skill or anything like that. But I'll explain that in a little bit. My point is, if they spent the time to actually update something on the test server and prepare the Leviathan update, as it were, before it ends up going live, that's another really good sign that they're starting to work on it again. Now, I'm not saying that the updates can't show up next week or anything like that, but hopefully, like, I know that they're really hoping they can get it out to us before the end of the year. And obviously, console players are probably just gonna have to wait for the update next year. But hopefully, we at least get the update out, you know? Like, that's the biggest thing. So, anyways, how do you actually end up preparing to fight these guys? Well, there's multiple different classes that you can choose from, but the most obvious would be, well, Scyushi, you said that it's an Ultra Shadow Tower boss, so it begs the question, does that mean you should be using the classes that are the strongest for Ultra Shadow Towers? Like, for me, the Draco is pretty much my best when it comes to Shadow Towers, because he's pretty much the easiest character to get through Ultra Shadow Towers with if you're soloing, just because he's really, really tanky while also having insane amounts of damage, right? He's technically not the strongest, Gunslinger is, but Gunslinger is way too squishy for me, and you have to, you know, you have to run around a lot, and trying to stay alive is really difficult. Dino Tamer can also stay alive pretty well, pretty easily as well, but you gotta dodge around a lot. Anyways, my point is that with the Draco and even just any other Ultra Shadow Tower classes, I'd say that you could probably use them very effectively in U8 and U9 for the Leviathans. That said, you're probably gonna have to use a couple origin portals to go and restock on your flasks, just because these guys, they take a little while, right? But then you gotta be careful, because if you have an origin portal down, it means that other players are gonna be able to crowd through that, and then you might end up losing those precious drops because there will be more than 8 people around. Now, when it comes to the U10 Geode Topside boss, that is going to end up being a whole other dilemma, because for that guy, I'd actually recommend Shadowhunter is probably going to be your absolute best bet. Yeah. Who'd have thunk Shadowhunter was going to end up being front and center above most of the other classes? And the reason why you're going to end up using Shadowhunter, you can use any character. You don't have to use Shadowhunter, honestly. I'm just going to use Shadowhunter because that's where I have all my gems. But otherwise, Ice Sage would be really good. Gunslinger would be fantastic, obviously. Fey Trickster would work very well. Ranged characters, you know, Dino Tamer. The key is ranged characters, because the boss in U10, unfortunately, has an ability that has no telegraph. Like, there's no indication that he's going to use this ability. It's just one of his attacks that he'll just hit you with. It's a spin move that will one-shot you even if you have Death Defying. That is where there is no skill whatsoever required of the player. There is no possible way that you can dodge this attack. And so, unfortunately, rather than what the devs are hoping for, where this boss is going to end up being challenging, it just ends up feeling cheap. And because of it, we have to use cheap tactics to become successful. So there is a couple things that you can end up doing with that in order to end up having better odds of fighting them. And let me actually hop into a portal over here and go to where I kind of just build stuff. So I'm gonna give you guys a very, very quick brief rundown of how you're going to end up building an arena to fight one of these guys, because the whole thing is that when you're fighting these Leviathans, you're basically going to end up being in a big old square space, right? Let's just say that this is the arena. Of course, downscaled, you know, to when you're actually inside it, it's going to end up being like the size of a dungeon when you're in here. And then there's going to end up being the boss itself. Let's just indicate him with the purple. That's going to end up being the boss right in the middle there. So essentially what you're going to end up trying to do is I'd say you lure it into the corner and then you just start pillaring up. Because what that's going to end up doing is that's going to end up sealing the boss in. And since he's got a huge hitbox, he's going to end up being stuck in here, and you'll be able to use your ranged characters to end up shooting him and taking him down. Maybe even some melee characters might be able to get in a little bit close, but you will have to watch out for that spinning attack. Now, there's all sorts of crazy elaborate things that people have told me that they've done. Another one that's fairly easy to do is the arena itself is going to end up basically being a gigantic pit. So what you can do is just start building a pillar all the way across, and then you can just shoot down at the boss. You know, that's another method that'll work if you don't want to bother actually trying to trap him, because trying to trap him could end up being quite risky. But the thing is that this boss is also going to end up having an ability to kind of funnel you in. So he's going to pull you in so he can use that attack. That's why you're going to have to try and build your towers across and you know, build him in the corner. You're trying to do this so that you're far enough away that his ability isn't going to end up pulling you in. That's what most, I think most of them actually have this ability. Maybe it's all of them. I haven't fought them enough to confirm though, guys, so maybe it's only a specific Leviathan that ends up having those abilities. But my point being is this is pretty much what you're gonna have to do for the U10 one guaranteed. You can very effectively do it for the other bosses, because originally you could actually just blast your way into the dungeon itself, but then they ended up changing it so that we can't destroy the environment inside their dungeon. And because of it, we're going to have to actually use cheap tactics, because like I said, unfortunately, this, the U10 one especially, like, all of them are overly powerful, okay? But if you're already at the end game, you'll be able to handle, and in fact, you'll probably be able to solo the U8 and U10 or U9 ones. It's not gonna be super duper fast. Obviously, you wanna have more than just yourself doing it. But most of all, I'm trying to think about this in long term. And long term, you know, I wonder whether or not this is going to end up being something that's the same, you know, guilty pleasure of the rampages, where barely anybody farms them anymore, because almost everybody that's at the end game and all powerful already has all of their badges out of the way. Excluding me, I don't have any of my rampage badges because I barely end up farming them. And because of it, I really, really struggle whenever the event ends up going live to end up finding a group that's actually farming for it. But I think that the Leviathans should end up being a they're implemented very well, so they should be something that stays popular throughout the game, because the Leviathans are pretty much the only true end game update that Trove has ever had. You know, like when we ended up having the GEODE topside, that's cool, and the GEODE topside in general works very, very well for the end game, because 5-star dungeons are pretty much the equal of doing 5 dungeons all in one, and thus you end up getting more gear and grinding your tomes faster, and everything about the game steps it up as soon as you get to the GEODE surface, right? But the Leviathans truly feel like the actual last boss, because with Shadow Towers, you know, they work, but they're a bit archaic and a little bit old. Like, Shadow Towers desperately need to have a big overhaul, and they're planning on doing that update. I think that might actually be the next update after the Leviathans, but we'll see, because the developers know that the Shadow Towers are not only really, really lame, but they're also extremely taxing on the servers, and they're trying to end up optimizing stuff like that so that hopefully we can end up seeing more of these updates coming out more regularly. Now, again, I want to reiterate, guys, I don't know when the Leviathan update is coming out. It could be months, honestly speaking, but I've seen a couple things that are hinting that it might end up being soon TM, okay? So we'll just kind of have to wait. But hopefully this ended up covering everything that you guys needed to know. Somebody suggested me to make a video like this so that you guys could prepare for this update, and I thought that that was actually a really good idea. I'd say as of right now, get your ranged characters as strong as you can, guys. Try to get a full set of magic gems, maybe physical if you want to be Shadow Hunter, like I'm probably going to be. Shadow Hunter's advantage is that he actually has the longest distance shot in the entire game, and that's where it will be very beneficial to be him, because you'll be very easily able to get out of the range of the suction move that the Leviathans can end up using. That said, his damage fall off is not going to end up being that good. Like, he's gonna have a lot of damage slowly but surely fall off to the side compared to other characters like the Gunslinger or even the Fae Trickster or Ice Sage that will just outright end up doing more damage overall towards these bosses. Hopefully you found this video helpful, guys. Smash like, sub for more, have yourselves a great day, buy some of the merch you want, support the channel. You guys know how it all goes. Really appreciate it, by the way, for those of you that have used the sign-up link for Trove and bought stuff out of the store, because it's helped me exponentially, guys, especially because YouTube isn't paying as much as it has been lately, which, I'll have another video talk about that, because boo-hoo, right? Sign or and stay epic, though, gamers.